In this video, we'll look at ellipsometry sample analysis using Semilab's SEA software. To begin analyzing the sample, select the SEA icon on the desktop. You will typically need to begin a new session by selecting on Sessions, New Session, and Empty Session. To import your measured data, click on the Measure menu and hit on the plus button to add your measurements. To add your particular measurements, find the relevant folder and select the SMDX file. This SMDX file will import all measurements made over a range of angles. Alternatively, the PAE files can select single angle measurements. When the measurement has been imported, you'll see on the data screen in yellow is your actual measurement and in blue is your model data. To begin your model, click on Structure. You can change the spectral unit and the parameters displayed depending on preference. I can also change your fit range depending on the sample features. The model structure is shown in the top left corner, where you first have the row layer of phases. Firstly, you start with air, next is your film phase, then finally your substrate. If you need to change your substrate, there's a set of library files. When you select a phase type NK file, click on Open. And from here, there's a range of library data files. Next, to change your layer, select either an NK file, which again is a library file, or more typically dispersion laws, which allows the user to select some common ellipsometric models for data analysis. To select the models, click on Law, and the drop-down menu give you a selection of all available models and software. The model that you will use depends on the material that you've coated onto your substrate. In this case, for a non-absorbing film, we use a Cauchy law. At this point, we start building our model. So firstly, an estimate of film thickness is typically required. The aim of this modeling process initially is to try and get the generated data to match up as closely as possible with the actual measured data. To do this, you can use the sliders provided for each parameter. From this, you can see the effect on the generated curves. before allowing the software to do the fitting, try and get as close as possible by playing around with several of the parameters. Again, you can either do this using the sliders or by manually inputting values. When you're satisfied with your initial estimate, you can select the Fit tab along the top. From here, you can allow the software to generate a fit based on parameters that you select. So it's generally recommended to select a minimum of parameters first, leaving the rest constant, and then clicking on Start Fit. Once this process has been completed, you can see the change in the fit that the software has carried out. R-squared values and RMSE to give you the goodness of fit, and also estimated N and K values. You can choose to accept this new fit by clicking on Update Structure, or reject it by clicking on Restore Structure. Alternatively, you can continue selecting further parameters to get a better fit. So once you're happy with the fit, there's several ways of exporting your data. To export the raw and fit data, you can click on the graph, right click, and save values to CSV, which allows for plotting of your own data. The system generates a PDF report. Which allows for compilation of all relevant data and results in PDF format. Here you will see all the model parameters, the film thickness, the refractive index values, and the fit values. Also, it will give you plots of the measured data and the fit values.